Hey everyone, hope you're doing well. I am Arya and today I'm excited to share some insights about the project I worked on. But before we move into that, let me give you a bit of information about myself. I am from India and I'm an undergraduate student pursuing a bachelor's in computer science engineering with a focus on artificial intelligence. In terms of my technical skills, I am good at Python, Java, and have experience in developing web applications. Now, let's talk about how I got involved with TuringWay. I became a part of TuringWay through Google Summer of Code 2023, also known as GSOC. It is a program conducted by Google to support open source software development. To contribute, participants need to select a project from the list of organizations and then submit a proposal. I found the project proposed by TuringWay under INCF interesting, and since I was familiar with the tech stack mentioned, I decided to move forward with it. I have two mentors as well. One is Malvika Sharan and other one is Johanna Bay. Now, let's talk about the project. The main aim of the project is to make the TuringWay website easier to use. This involves making improvements to a Python package that the team made in 2022. The purpose of this package is to enhance the website's usability by creating personalized starting points for users called pathways. As you can see, the image on the slide shows various pathways. The idea is to simplify navigation for users. For example, if someone is an early career researcher or a project leader, they should be able to easily navigate the book's content that suits their needs. This is done through the pathways feature, where users can easily explore a selected set of chapters. So in short, the project focuses on improving this feature and making other changes to enhance the usability of the website. Now, let's talk about my contributions. During the community building period of GSOC, I participated in BookDash. During BookDash, my main goal was to gather ideas to make the website easier to use. I had one-to-one conversations with users to get their thoughts on using the pathways in the book. We even did some screen sharing sessions where users showed me how they browse. I also made a feedback form to hear from more users. Their feedback helped in understanding how pathways affect the browsing and where can we make things better. The next contribution I made is enhancing the browsing experience for users who are exploring a single profile. In the previous version, when users navigate the book using pathways, all the profile badges appear at the top of the chapter. This will negatively impact the browsing experience for users focused on exploring a single profile. So I worked on it so that the users will only see the profile they selected. Initially, my solution was to modify the hyperlinks by adding the details of the profile selected by the users as a search parameter of the hyperlink. But during the implementation and testing, I discovered that this idea would create other issues. So in the final and revised approach, the profile selected by the user is stored using session storage. Session storage is a web storage mechanism that allows data to be stored in the user's browser during a single session. The profile selected by the user is then fetched from the session storage and used to add the current badges of these chapters. The next contribution is pathway description feature. In the previous version, as shown in the image, the landing page of the profiles lacked descriptions. This made it less meaningful. To address this, I implemented a new functionality to incorporate descriptions for all profiles. These descriptions can now be specified in profiles.yml file. As the book is being built, these descriptions are retrieved and added to the landing pages of all the profiles. The updated version is shown in the image. The next one is Python package integration. The implementation and testing of the Python package were done in a test repository named BioTuringWay. So I worked on integrating the Python package with all the changes to the main repository. And during the integration process, I faced certain challenges such as version conflicts and all, so I had to resolve them as well. Lastly, I attempted to add text-to-speech functionality to the website. I used WebSpeech API for text-to-speech generation, and at present, the implementation is in its initial stages, and there is room for several improvements. Also, using the WebSpeech API is found to have limitations, including variations in the voice quality based on the user's operating system and compatibility issues with the different browsers. Thank you all for listening. If you have any questions or thoughts, feel free to reach out to me.